Okay, welcome to our new series, Ask a Question at Roma, with two guests here tonight, Costas and Justin. Justin, welcome to Rome. Hope you're enjoying it so far. We're psyched to have you here. So I think the first question, I might as well start with you. Okay, let's see. What did you think of all the fans that were waiting to meet you at Rome Airport?
I actually wasn't expecting it. So yes, it was wonderful. It was a moment to never forget, and it was a warm feeling for me when the fans were waiting on me. Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Did you see me in the back? I kept waving to you at the airport.
No, I didn't see.
No, you didn't see. No, I was there. I was waving. Yeah.
Oh,
yeah.
Sorry.
On to you. Oh, this one's easy. I mean, you almost had a fight with Dzeko when you played for Greece. How badly would have he beaten you?
We had a fight, but not so strong. I don't know if he's gonna beat me or not. We have to fight first for beat me.
Okay, you know what? We can do that after the training today. It's in about 2 hours. I think you can take him if you go low, right? If you go up high on him, you're not gonna take him down, but I think you get him down low, I think you got him.
Everything
a little,
has
right?
one strategy.
Take out the knee?
Of course. Yeah. No, but after we have to pay one attackant.
That's right, so. Yeah, that's right. But we have insurance.
So, I go?
You take one.
What were you thinking as you walked towards that fountain?
Well, I mean, when you look back on it, obviously I wasn't thinking, right? I mean, I was. It was sort of the moment. I don't remember who scored the third goal. I don't know. I'm not sure who scored that third goal. But, you know, it was the interesting part was that in the stadium, first of all, when you scored, I didn't go crazy. I watched everybody in the stadium, and I just couldn't believe how crazy people were going. I mean, just the joy and everything. I mean, and you running around like a six-year-old was fantastic. Because it just shows you at the end of the day what sports are all about. And it doesn't matter that you're a big professional, that in a moment like that, how you go back to your almost childhood. And it's just pure joy. So when we got back to the hotel in the Piazza di Popolo, what was amazing is the entire staff of the hotel, I mean, literally 25 people were outside with Roma shirts on and scarves. And I started walking into the hotel, and then one of them said, there's thousands of fans out by the fountain. You know, you should go say hi to them. And Zecca and the others are trying to talk me out of it. I go, no, this will be fun. But about halfway there, I'm looking at the fountain and the fans, and I started taking off my jacket and my tie. You know, I kind of knew like, oh, here we go again. Because it's not the first time I've jumped in a fountain. It's the first time I've gotten fined in the fountain, but it wasn't the first time that I've jumped in a fountain. So I'm not sure I was thinking. I did know that about 4 hours later when I woke up in the morning, I woke up and I said, I don't think you're supposed to jump in the fountains. And about an hour later, they fined me. So it was worth it. Rumor has it that every single morning and every night, you watch the goal you scored at Barcelona on replay. True or false?
True. I can say that I watch it a lot of times. Even now, before the game with Barcelona, all the fans sent me messages with this goal because it was one of the biggest moments, how you said before. And I like it because I like to hear the commentators, how we say,
commentators
of the game, that they say Greek god, you know, you remember.
Yep.
And I like it, I am looking it. I say the truth.
Yeah, but you know, it gives you motivation, huh?
Of course, yeah. To do it again.
Yeah, okay, good.
I hope. This is difficult.
Is it?
What player living at Roma was the hardest for you? The player that lived was hardest.
I mean, is this leaving Roma in terms of retirement or leaving?
No, leaving.
Leaving. You know, Salah was, I liked Salah a lot, but you know, unbeknownst to a lot of people, or a lot of people don't seem to know, is that we didn't have a choice in him leaving, so it was difficult. And that, you know, he had 1 year left, and he asked to leave, and he felt like he had something to prove back in the Premier League. So it was difficult. It was difficult for that point. I think Alisson's not a easy one. You know, Raja on the pitch is a warrior. I can't say, it's almost like saying, you know, who's your favorite of the 11 players? So it's each, you know, in a lot of those cases, it's just like you don't have choices. You think, you know, people outside think you have choices, and a lot of time you just don't have choices, so you try to make the best of it, you know, and you hope that you bring in people that, you know, have good character, and you bring in people that, you know, may be better and stuff, or at least as good and stuff like that. It's not an easy, you know, people think it's easy and you're like trading people and stuff like that, at least for me and I think for the staff out here, it's not an easy thing. There's a lot of thought that goes into that stuff, and then many times it's just you get no choice.
The older players said that you personally buy every player who scored 10 goals a Lamborghini. Is that true?
It wasn't a Lamborghini. I thought it was, we got one Lamborghini, but the rest of them were Ferraris.
Could we make this deal this year again, or?
I'll tell you what, if you score 30 goals.
30?
Yeah.
Okay,
yeah.
I wanna hear.
If you score 10 goals, you want a Lamborghini? Is that your, what's your car of choice? What's your favorite car? What do you drive now? Do you drive? Do you have a license?
Yes, I have a license, No, I just have a little Mercedes.
A new Mercedes? Yeah?
We can make a deal on that.
Okay, we're going to have to think about that one with the Lamborghinis for 10 goals. That might be easily worth it.
This was for me, this question.
That was for you?
Okay.
But you're never going to score 10 goals, are you?
I scored 5, not bad.
If you score 10 goals, I'll get you a Lamborghini. No, no, because then you'll just start going crazy.
I have already.
What's, yeah.
I have.
You have a Lamborghini now?
Yeah.
Really? What color?
Urus. White.
White?
Mm-hmm. It's coming.
It's coming?
It's on the road from America. I didn't pay yet. If you want, you can.
I'll pay for the. You score 10 goals, I'll pay for the gas for the next 5 years.
When De Rossi retire, will you make me captain?
Read the right question, come on. No, is it? it's not up to me to make you captain, actually. I actually think that the captain spot should be a lot of input from the players and how the players feel about, you know, who's been leading the team or helps to lead the team, whether or not they are the captain beforehand. So, you know, I think I have to tell you, from the day you came in the first couple of years to how you are right now is very, very different in an unbelievably great and positive way for me, and I think for everybody on the team. You know, I think you were a very confident, cocky, young shit. And it was good to have that part of it, but I think, you know, you've morphed into it. I can see it a lot last year. And a lot of people are saying it to me now, you've just morphed into an incredibly, I think, fine young man and a teammate. You know, I don't see any reason why you continue on that path, that you're not as you are, I think, right now, being here as long as you have a leader on the team. I mean, really, really feel, you know, feel good about what you've been doing, and I'm glad you're here.
Thank you. Are you in charge of Roma's Twitter account?
Am I in charge of it?
Yeah.
No, actually, it's somebody in Nigeria that's got it.
What did you think when Juve signed Ronaldo?
You know, honestly, I thought it was good for Serie A, first and foremost. I didn't look at it as a big negative for Roma at all. I mean, he's a spectacular player and, you know, arguably one of the best ever. But I didn't look at it as, oh my God, Juve's got Ronaldo. I looked at it that I thought it was good for Serie A because I thought in the last few years that Serie A was being underestimated in the rest of the world. From a top to bottom, I think Serie A is as good a league as there is. Literally, I mean, I think in Spain there's, you know, four or five good teams, and I think in Germany, small number, and France, a small number, and the Premier League, maybe six or seven or so, and I think there's at least that in Serie A, and I think it's very, very difficult for a lot of teams to go into a lot of different places to play, and tactically and strategically, it's a different game than a lot of other leagues. So I wasn't sitting there and going, oh, he's going to come in and score 60 goals. Now, God forbid if he does. But, you know, I wasn't thinking like that. I actually thought that, you know, he would potentially have a more difficult time than in Spain. And I'm not trying to give him, you know, some fodder to prove me wrong. But it's just, I just think that Italy's different. And I thought just generally it was better for Serie A than anything else. Then I was trying to figure out how the hell they paying him.
When you were 19, my age, what were you doing with your life and did you think of what being successful?
Ooh, okay, so when I was 19, I was just coming off my freshman year in college. And I had an unbelievably impressive year in college in my freshman year. So in colleges, you know, you can have up to a 4.0. grade average, right? So the grade average of a 4.0 was having all A's. So my freshman year and going into 19 years old, I had what was a 1.1. Yeah, so really, really impressive. So at 19, I could remember my father saying, kid, what are you thinking about? And I was like, I'm really not thinking, I guess. I had no idea what I was going to do, that I think I would be successful. No, I mean, I never even thought that way. Yeah, at that time, no. I was just trying to get through, you know, maybe getting through college, and I wasn't starting it off that well. All right, Justin, I saw an old quote where you said you dreamed of playing for Barcelona. You know I'm not going to ever sell you to Barcelona.
No, okay.
Okay.
No problem.
Was that the right... You did dream of playing for Barca?
I always
Is that like every little kid wants to play for Barca?
It was, I think, because my father played for a club. I think that is a reason, but I'm happy here, so. Let me take this one. You have signed two players in the summer, and I'm your favorite.
11
players this summer.
I thought...
My favorite?
Am I your favorite?
Absolutely, absolutely. Yeah? And as soon as I get out there and Pastore asks me, I'm going to say the same thing. No. If you had not become a footballer, what job would interest you?
I was always interested in tennis.
Oh, yeah?
I started tennis after I went to playing soccer. And tennis, I like that.
Who's your favorite?
Yeah, Rafa Nadal, I think he's very good. Yeah, better if a good player. Who do you think is better?
For me, it's Federer.
Well, Nadal, I think he's a nice left hand.
Who are you most looking forward to playing against, Ronaldo or Raja?
Raja is one of my friends. I look forward to play against Ronaldo because everything knows that Ronaldo is one of the best football players in the world, and I'm looking forward to play against him and make a good performance.
You know he's going to be coming a lot down your side, right?
No problem.
Yep,
we'll have to find it after we will see.
You got it.
Going to be the winner.
You got the speed and the size and everything to knock him off.
You said on the radio that I reminded you of a young Allen Iverson.
Yep.
What did you mean?
Yeah, I mean, but what I meant was, you know, Iverson, the way he would break down people and his moves. And when I'm watching that film, some of those moves and some of the spins and how you would like freeze people, which Allen would do a lot. I saw him a lot. You'd freeze them and then they're like, and then you take off another way in another direction was pretty much what I meant.
But he lost from Greece, if you remember. Semi-final, World Cup.
You know that.
Remember or not?
Who's up?
You.
My turn? All right. We'll go back to Justin. Your playlist doesn't have Jay-Z or Kanye. Too old for you?
No, because I think if I could put more numbers, there would be Jay-Z or Kanye in it. But yeah, those are like the type of music that I really listen. Mm-hmm. But besides that, Jay-Z and Kanye are top artists.
Yeah, so who do you like?
Who do I like? I like Drake a lot.
Okay.
Drake is my...
So we're going to get Drake here for you.
Okay.
So, yeah.
I like to hear that.
Yep.
And yeah, Drake is actually, the best, I think.
Okay. So if you get 20 goals, then we'll bring Drake in. How's that?
Deal?
All right, that's an easy one.
That's the one.
You cried after the Barcelona game. Was that the most emotional that you've been?
Of course. It was my biggest moment in football. I think it was one of the biggest moments of AS Roma in football.
For sure. At least,
and
certainly
so
mine, I'm
after,
sure before.
After one, we have a lot of pressure.
Mm-hmm.
Pressure, and you know this pressure come when you win 3-0 and you see all the people crazy, you get crazy. And I want a little moment alone, and I express it like this.
You know, I cried too. Not at the game, but later when I was by myself, I just couldn't believe it. So that was the last question. I think this was actually a lot of fun for me. Got me thinking a lot, and with the two of the guys, I think was great. I think this was fun and enjoyed it.
Fun.